Welcome all of you for this course on one and two dimensional NMR spectroscopy for chemists. I am Professor Surya Prakash from NMR Research Center, Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore. My main area of research is on the methodological developments, that is the design of novel NMR experimental techniques to address the challenging problems such as the analysis of complex NMR spectra and the extraction of spectral parameters in an orchestrated manner. My group is also working on enantiomeric discrimination, which is of very high importance in pharmaceutical industry. We also work on weak molecular interactions, especially the hydrogen bonding involving organic fluorine, where we look at molecules that are synthesized in our laboratory. Now coming to NMR Research Center, we have 8 spectrometers, sophisticated equipments, whose frequencies range from 400 megahertz to 800 megahertz. All these NMR instruments have capabilities to carry out the latest state-of-the-art experiments, both in the solid state and in the solution state. If any of you happens to visit our NMR Research Center, I can take you through a small tour of the department when I can brief you about the capabilities of all the equipments we have. Now coming to this course, we will begin with the conceptual understanding of NMR spectroscopy, including spin physics. Then I will discuss about external and internal interactions that are responsible for giving the NMR spectra, especially the internal interactions such as chemical shifts and scalar couplings. These are the very two important parameters which most of you chemists will be regularly dealing with. NMR is basically an insensitive technique compared to other spectroscopic techniques. So I'll be discussing sensitivity issues and also sensitivity enhancement techniques such as INEPT. Carbon-13 is another extensively utilized nuclei. So I'll discuss in detail about coupled and decoupled carbon-13 NMR spectra and identification of carbons based on the number of protons attached to each carbon by experimental techniques called APT and DEPT, attached proton test and distortionless enhancement polarization transfer. I will also discuss about the relaxation mechanisms, NOE phenomenon, and measurement of relaxation times and determination of nuclear overhazard enhancement, etc. Now coming to two-dimensional techniques, I will introduce the concept of two-dimensional NMR and discuss some of the basic pulse sequences. We discuss important two-dimensional experiments such as COSI, TOXI, HSQC, HMBC, and result type experiment like J-result, both in homonuclear and heteronuclear cases. And in each of these techniques, when I am discussing, I'll try to give large number of examples, especially the analysis of one-dimensional proton spectra and the spectra of various other heteronuclei, analysis of two-dimensional NMR spectra, so that you will become more comfortable with more number of examples given. I'm confident by the end of this course, in the next couple of weeks, you will be comfortable enough to decide about the type of experiment you would like to do for your sample, get an appropriate NMR spectra and interpret it and get the information that you require. I aim to do that. I know audience is heterogeneous. Many of you are from different backgrounds, from different schools, with different levels of exposure for the subject. I'm sure I will not be able to tell everything in the short span of time. You will have some doubts and clarifications required, which we can discuss in the forum. Let me tell you, NMR is a big ocean. I will not be able to discuss all these topics in depth, because that it is going to be a huge task. In the short span of time, it is impossible to do it. Nevertheless, I'll give you a lot of ideas which should act as a precursor for your research activity, or it should act as a springboard for you to jump to the advanced techniques at a later stage. So let us keep going. In the next couple of weeks, we'll be discussing together many, many concepts, many, many experimental techniques, and how to analyze NMR spectra, etc. Well, let us keep working together and learn together. Looking forward to interaction with all of you. Thank you.